May it be an evening star shines down upon you. May it be when darkness falls, your heart will be true.
Before I pass along, Inscribe the words of God and much of history. Many here was I, which out upon the sea the waves would wash my tears, the wind my memory. I'd hear the ocean breathe, exhale upon the shore. I knew the tempest blood, its wrath I would endure. And so the years went by within my rocky cell, with only a mouse or a bird, my friend I loved well. And so it came to pass I'd come here to
And hello there, Twitch TV. How are you doing on this lovely Saturday evening? At least it is where I am. Let's see, let's welcome to the stream. We got Cobalt Commando in the house. Welcome, Epic Sniper 33. Great to see you back. Fluffy Octopus, great to see you here. We've got Moldy Almonds, welcome. Pink Bunny is hanging out. Shadowfang 22 is here. Awesome, awesome. And Uzi Monkey looks like he's probably lurking again. Welcome everyone to the stream. And tonight we are continuing our playthrough of Viking Mountain Blade War Band. Blah, 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 blah. Boy, I better get that talking straightened out. Mountain Blade War Band Viking Conquest. We are loading our game with our Anglo-Saxon, warrior leader person, Crawmerax. We're on day 9. And we've gotten to the point in the game where we're given our first ship. We are playing sandbox mode, but you know what? It looks like that I was calling it the tutorial quest last time, but it seems like this is the main quest. It's kind of like Skyrim in that it is an open-world RPG, but there is a main quest for you to do. So I guess we are actually playing the main quest. Now, we have a whole huge map to play in, so when we're done with this main quest, you'd better believe we're going to be sandboxing it up and taking over at least one of these kingdoms. But for now, we are just some nobody named Crawmerax. He's got 27 guys, one of whom is named Ragin' Hard, and I just can't help but giggle when I say that. I went ahead and we couldn't get on our ships because we had 15 people too many. Off camera, while the game was, when I was had the title card going, we, or rather I, disbanded 16 of our least veteran troops, so we should be good to go into the ship now, and here we go. Oh, excellent. Switch to water consequences. Okay. Weird message. Alright, so we're sailing. Let's check our quest journal to see what we need to do. See, I chose to kill the Viking prisoner in Dachinga. Yeah. Let's see. So I chose not to give the land to the monastery. I chose to respect the life of Theodred's wife and son. You chose not to openly become the enemy of Jarl Hrolldorf Haraldsson for his betrayal and alliance with Jarl Sigurd Ragnarsson, Sven Bull-Neck's patron. You chose to kill the Viking prisoner. Okay, so that's the story so far. Those are the major choices, and those are the ones that we made. So let's go ahead and look at our next quest here, the Revenge. Sven Bull-Neck Hirsfer and Jarl Sigurd Ragnarsson, Snake in the Eye Jarl, famous warriors in Denmark. You'll have to be careful if you intend to fight them. Actually, it told us to go to a particular place. Ah, yes, the portmaster of Reba. May know where Sven Bull-Neck's hideout is. Talk to him and convince him that you have information regardless. One often finds him outside by the docks. And see, what is this? You have offered your services. Oh, right, I was going to kill the king for the Jarl, because somebody was like, be a bad guy, kill the king! But then we got distracted by a raid on the town that we love so very much, and ended up saving the town, which, ironically, was not what the Jarl Rodolf wanted us to do. So anyway, leave Friese. Your relationship with the Jarl has ended badly. He accused you of ruining his plans to take the throne. It's best not to pass crafts with him for some time, or until you're able to regain his friendship. All plans of the Jarl to be king have been ruined by my intervention. That his ally, the Danish Jord, Snake in the Eye, will not send more troops because he is recruiting reinforcements in Englaland. It seems Friese will be free from Viking attacks for some time, thanks to me. The paradox is that you now have to run away from the land that you just helped save. Herp-a-derp-a-derp. Okay, so we need to go to Rida. See where that is. There it is. So let's go ahead and sail. Yes, let's go sail. Okay. Alright, it looks like I have to control... Whoa! I have to control this manually. And also, the game dynamically generates these landing points. So that's fun. I wonder if I can go right to the port. In this ship. Or do I have to dock somewhere? Well, it looks like I can clip into the ground on the port. There we go. Switch to land consequences. Alright, here we are. We pulled up to the port. Town of Reba seems unremarkable. Wares in the market are of decent quality, and traders seem to bring luxury goods. Okay, so let's take a stroll through town to find the person we need to talk to. He's not... let's see, you use a pro, since the update config, you know a good setup for me to use on it. I actually do not know Shadowfang offhand. And you're right, I don't hear frickin' music either. Well, that is a shame. Do we have sound? Oh, we don't have sound because I muted it. Well, that was silly of me. Let's turn on the sound. Here we go. Alright. I love you. I love you all. Okay. So, let's take out our weapons in case bad things happen. Okay, so we are looking for someone by the docks. We need to find this portmaster by the docks. But I read chat. You just gotta realize that there is a delay. It looks like tonight it might be a full minute. It is now 6:22 as I am talking. So that might help you figure out if there's a delay. Okay. We're looking, traditionally, in these games, when you're looking for someone by the dock, they are going to be a static person. He's probably that guy over there, actually. All on his lonesome. Standing beneath something. Not kill the townswoman. I doubt he would be on the ship talking to somebody. And he probably isn't fishing. Let's go ahead and talk. Talk to this dude over here. Slave trader. Well, that actually is not who we want to talk to, but... okay, he's going to give us the same... there we go. I needed to sell those prisoners, so that ended up being a good boon for us. Let's talk to this townsperson. Okay, bread. Okay, what can you tell me about this town? No. Oh, no. Let's see. How did Direwolf go? Oh, yeah, Pardue / Ingeek needed my help setting up an ender tank that was pumping lava from the nether. We got it working. That was what was going on. Okay, we've got a physician here, an old sea captain, and some townsmen. Okay, that's not who we're looking for. Let's check our notes again. The portmaster. One often finds him outside by the docks. Okay. So we gotta look for this portmaster person. Okay, that is our ship right there. Let's see here. For the portmaster. Let me guess. He's gonna be in the town? A little bit? No, not right on the docks, perhaps? Because that says outside. This is so old school. This is one reason why I like the Mount & Blade game so much, is that, you know, in Skyrim and newer games, you have this compass that knows all and does all and knows where everybody is all the time. And while that is convenient for a lot of reasons, there is something to be said about having to explore a town to find somebody based on a verbal description that some other character has given you. I say as I wander around town without finding anyone. But yeah, it's some people look at that today and are like, now there's a glitch. I'm pretty sure there's not supposed to be water right there. Your town is flooded, sir. What do you have to say about that? So I shouldn't call this a mod anymore. This is DLC now. The DLC looks like it still has a couple of buggery do's here. He's right on the docks of two men. Okay, Frere2, thank you so much. I was just trying to chat it up and say that, you know, these old-fashioned quests are great. But sometimes, like, he's outside by the docks. That doesn't help too much. Okay, he's on the docks by the two men. I was like, he's probably not over here, so I'm going to go over here. Freeholder Bondi, Portmaster, my gosh. Welcome, sir, what do you need? You know what I want. Let's see. Want you to build me a ship? I probably don't have money for that. He approaches you until you can smell the cheap beer on his breath. Why so loud, friend? Nobody important needs to know what you are talking about. I see someone has told you about me. That's fine, it's the way that businesses thrive. Well, you want to know the location. It is not hard to get, but it has a cost, of course. Not a cheap one. Bull-Neck Sven is a dangerous man. He looks with a perverse look. Listen carefully. Fortunately, I need someone like you. I need you to become a raider of sort and go to Euryland. I have a client who wants a book kept in a monastery there as a relic. The monastery is called Glendalough. The name of the book is the Kathak Column, it's whatever. I am really only interested in the book. Anything else you take is yours. Bring me that book and you will know where Sven Bull-Neck is hiding. I prefer to forget about that book and offer pennies for the information. Well, isn't that an interesting option? My client offers me 10,000 pennies for the book. Do you have that kind of money? No. I'll bring the book. I will see you soon. Dang it! Okay, so the game decided we need to go to the book. Well, I'll be here. I suggest you repair and provision your ship. The trip to Euroland is long, and bring enough men for the Euro War enough on each other to have become quite good at it. Oh, okay. I'm already up at the maximum number of men. Now, this guy, he looks like he's a little tougher. Oh, I thought I could hire him. But I guess not. Travel to another port. Kyle, are you looking to travel to another town? From here, one may travel to the ports in Friese, Danmark, North Vegger, and Englaland. Where do you want to go? Not want to go. Edinburgh. Can we check our map before we do any of this here? Go ahead and check our map. Where is the nearest port to Ireland? Actually, let's locate the monastery here. Let's check the name. All this old school stuff. Being a Viking. Monastery of Mesitsu. Show on map. Come on. Oh, crap. Okay, I know it probably thinks it's centered on something, but okay, there it is. I have to assault that. Oh, gravy. Okay, so the nearest thing from there that we could get to was... Kyr Diff right there. I don't think that was on the list, though. It looks like we can get to Dunwich, or Dunwick. Or Edinburgh is probably too far north. Okay, so Dunwich we go. Alright, so back into town. Okay, I would like to... Actually, I'd like to get to my boat. Sail from the port. Okay. Wind has become a stiff breeze. Severe weather has damaged my ship. Great. But you have a boat. You have infinite ammo on the boat. Awesome. I am not doing storyline mode. This is the main quest of sandbox mode. Okay. I think we are finally near here. Okay. Seems to want to chug. Severe weather has damaged my boat again. I might want to stop and get it repaired. I'm not sure. Weather is breezy. I am not quite sure if we're gonna... Severe weather has damaged my ship again. I need to find a port or something where I can repair the ship. Wind has become a gale. That's not good. I'm sailing along the coast here because know, that's what the Vikings did. Yes. So there is, like, even in sandbox mode, there's a main quest, which is pretty cool. I kind of like that. It gave us a bunch of free stuff. I mean, got a free boat. Let's travel to the port of Caradin there. We are traveling extremely slowly now because of the damage, presumably. So we need to limp this thing into port and get it fixed. I do hope it doesn't, you know, like, crap out on us and drown my whole party. In fact, I may just want to save the game. Game it a little bit. Did I start the storyline already? Yes, this is part of the storyline of the main quest. I haven't done, like, the actual story campaign. Because... I don't know, I didn't think it would be as free-form. So this is the sandbox mode, but like Skyrim, it's open world, but there is a main quest and a main story, it looks like, even in sandbox mode. So I can understand why there might be some confusion about that. This is the, this is the sandbox mode. This is not the story quest that they teased. This is something different. Ah, no wind. Okay, in any case, let's, can I not come into port at night? Is that the problem? Alright, well then we'll hold space and just weigh anchor out here. Midnight, late night. Waiting for dawn. Come on, dawn. Here we go. Okay, switch to land consequences. It turns out we didn't actually come to port. I want to go to port. How do I go to port? Why won't it let me? I mean, there's a landing point there. Faction eliminated. The Kingdom of Vrishnyog is no more. Gadok. Whatever. Can we get our ship repaired? No, because we're not in the port. Would like to get my ship repaired at the port. Not at the beaches. Alright, whatever. You know what? We're gonna make the crossing. Why is this under pause? I don't know why we couldn't go to port there. Very strange. Let's try to land by the actual... We'll land at Glendioc here. Up the coast. Glendioc. Okay. Landing point. Bonk. Okay, we gotta keep track of that. Vlagan. Alright, army. Do we have anyone we can promote? No, but we can promote myself and the characters with us. Okie doke. Attributes and skills. I have 2 points. Let's dump those into tactics. And... leadership. There we go. Two-handed weapons, because we have one, and I guess we're done. Now we need to go to the army and talk to Raging Hard, who actually needs better equipment. And what can you tell me about your skills? Attribute points 1. Okay, let's put it into charisma. We're going to make him our, like, support character. So he's the one in charge of training and tracking. And let's see here. What else is a support type thing for him to do? His trade is already good. Pathfinding. And I guess training some more. All right. He's going to be Viking like us. And you, Brunhilde. What can you tell me about my skill? Ooh, 6 points. I must have really neglected her. Bump up her surgery all the way. All right. So this means that very few of our men will hopefully get killed permanently. All right. So, all right. Everybody is leveled up at least. We've got the best weapons we can afford already. And this is, again, I'm just Raid a monastery near my Sitsu. Okay, so this must be the monastery. Pray and make a donation. Pillage the monastery! Place stretches out wide with a church, rooms amongst. Okay, pillage it! Alright. Everybody, follow me. Really should have bought a horse. Alright. Get our shield out. Get our axe out. Everybody sounds like they're behind me. Yep. Come on, men and woman. Blood for the blood god. That's right. Oh, this is actually fortified here. Here come the monks? Yeah, here come the monks! Now everyone can charge. Yep. And immediately it becomes a cluster fudge. Alright. Killed a monk! Ha! Those monks, they never stood a chance. I needed to put points into my athletic skill, wasn't that it? Alright. Killed him. Alright, monkey wonky. Alright. Alright, we've pillaged a monastery, excellent. Okay, captured enemies, monk. Let's capture them. Sounds fun. And there's no book here? Well, we did find a lot of stuff we could possibly sell. Blood and treasure. Those of your men with fewer scruples are sent towards Gleaned a Lot, killing anyone in their path and plundering its riches. The fire and death sweeping the place are rampant. Your plunder spoils of war worth 1,200 pennings. In the arms of the dead abbot, your men find the Cathach of Cullum Shield. Brunhilde! Okay. Leave the place. Quest succeeded. Got item. Okay. Back into our ship. Perhaps it is not my place to say so, sir, but I confess that I am somewhat shocked that we attack innocent people. Of course, I realize that war is cruel, but there is no need to make it more cruel than necessarily. Toot the same options from the regular Mountain Blade. Hopefully it won't happen again. Okay, so now we're back on the water. Maybe we can actually go to this port here and get the ship repaired. A long journey. We've taken a lot of damage. Okay, hold on. We gotta pixel this. Why am I not able... There we go. We were able to dock in that port. Let's see. Roll through the town. I need to find the portmaster. A horse merchant. I actually do need a horse. We need a horse. Oh, welcome everyone. I just looked at the chat to see to catch up on it, and welcome Quack and Silver Domed and Slider and M Follett and Square 2 and Purifex, Don John. Welcome everyone. Great to see so many new faces in here tonight. Awesome. Just trying to find the portmaster to repair our ship so we can get back home. Well, I guess I won't call it home. We don't have a home yet. We are a vagrant robbing monasteries for books I don't actually want. Physician, old sea captain. It seems like the physician and the old sea captain are... Okay, slave trader. I've brought some prisoners. Alright, let's sell them all for money. We're getting quite wealthy now. Well... Hello, stranger. Do you have a trade? How is trade? Want to buy a farmstead? I don't want to do any of these things right now. I was hoping he'd be like the portmaster. This must be the portmaster over here. I want to see about repairs to my ship. Monks! That's right! We kidnapped some monks for a story quest. I just sold them off. I have some questions about ship and sea travel. I want to travel to another port. I want you to build me a ship. Actually, I want to repair the ship I have. I want a Nor for trading. Go to attack Snekia. I have many warriors can build a boost for me. A bus! I wonder if that's the etymology of the word bus. Interesting. Mind. Follow me. Fleet capacity. Okay, price. Holy crud. Repair. My boats. Repair ship. There we go. Alright, yeah, repair it. It is now repaired. Ooh, customized ship. Wood, ash, sail plane, finish plane. Change sail. Change sail. If that's all we can do, nuts to it. Cancel. Alright, ship's repaired. Back. Alright, sail from port. Let's get the fudge back to Port of Reba. Gotta sail across the whatever this is. Okay. Sail across. Your party loses one morale. Why? The wages? We paid our wages. Winter is the worst time of year. It's cold, it rains much, and the food is scarce. In winter, men would rather shelter by the fire than be on the... Okay, so it's because I'm out at night. Okay, well, I'm not... We're not making this take longer than it needs to. You're outside in winter. That's why you lost morale. Yeah. No, I almost never, just a forewarning, I almost never look at the condition of my ship. I just repair it if it has the option. Because I figure it has damage. I mean, we know it has damage because it says you've been damaged. I'm just obsessive compulsive that way. I would like to customize my ship by renaming it. I have some great ship names. I'm kind of hoping that by keeping it close to the coast here, that we don't take so much damage, but I don't think the game does it that way. used. Keep getting severe weather damage. Looks like I gotta click every little whip stitch, otherwise it stops automatically. And it likes to, the game likes to hang when it creates a landing point. That's kind of... Alright. We're gonna take some morale hits again. Hit the coast. And we didn't lose morale today. Okay, so let's go along the coast of Friese again. Sail north. Austin, welcome to the stream. EDB Rob Price, welcome as well. And also welcome YUOP. I probably messed up your name, but welcome to the stream too. Oh, Kenimer, someday we will take you in war. You will rue the day. Okay. Get up to Reba. Oop, there we go. Or to Reba. Okay. There we go, and we're now in port. Should be able to just stroll through town and find the portmaster. Always have weapons out in case things go bad. Alright. Making progress. The graphics on this are much better than in the vanilla game, I have to say. Much better. A lot of people were complaining on the forums about the faces being ugly, and quite frankly, I think the faces are much better than in the vanilla game. You can land in camp. This is true. I messed with the camp before, and it cost me money to set up camp, and I don't have lots of money. Welcome, sir. What do you need? I did your thing. Give me the book, and I will tell you what you asked about. Here, take it. Where's Sven's hideout? I gained 10 renown, and I got 600 experience. Well, thank you. The hideout is in here, in Denmark, northeast of Reba, up the river. Fare thee well. What do you need? I don't need anything right now. Apparently it's going to be on my map. So I'm guessing that let's just leave. We know that the ship is here. Rolls Bridge Lumber Camp. Sven's hideout. We probably want more men than we have for this excursion. So let's go see if we can slave some peasants or something. Or come across any robbers we can forcefully recruit. Oh yeah, I forgot they did that system. Okay. You need permission of the head of the village to recruit here. Go to the village center. Maybe I can do a quick odd job that's actually quick. And get recruitment rights. Or maybe not, who knows. Olaf the Elder. Good day, and welcome to Reba by South. I am the leader of this village. I am recruiting. What can I say? My influence here is vast. May you listen to what I say and suggest. I will not allow you to take men who work the land, but there are others. Landless losers that contribute nothing more than misery. I could ask them to join you, but you don't look like much of a leader to follow, and you will likely take them to their deaths, and they will never return. Surely even people like them don't deserve such a fate. Here, take these 500 pennings. Well, you have my permission to take those troublemakers off my hands. I think they are eager for adventure anyway. You may go to the center of the village and take anyone loitering there. For every recruit you take from this village, I'll take a commission. Okay. So I can recruit villagers? the town center. Maybe he's just... No one here wants to join your party. Well, fudge you. That was time well spent. Yeah, I like the faces and bodies. You're right. It is well done, I thought. Okay, well, maybe we can find some thieves or something to attack and force them to join us or something. Actually, what is my inventory like? I can sell a bunch of... I can sell much of this stuff because it seems perishable. And get more money. Okay. And then, of course, tomorrow I can go back to Reeb by south and get more people. Okay. We could also try hiring some mercenaries, but that didn't work out so well last time. Trade with the locals. Hey, with the goods merchant. Let's sell this beef we're not eating. Sell this cheese we're not eating. Let's sell this pork we're not eating. Sell this barley we're not eating. Okay, I will receive 300 pennies. Not as much as I would hope. Alright. Get out of here. Just joined. Is this Denmark? This is Denmark. That is correct. And we are... Well, we are able to attack Sven Bull-Neck, the chief antagonist of the main quest. But something tells me I need something more than 27 men to do that. Because the previous battles in the storyline have been very difficult. So I'm trying to figure out ways I can recruit more people. Can I recruit people from here yet? No, not yet. You can recruit once per day, at least if it follows the traditional Mountain Blade Warband rules. I'm also looking for thieves, and I can force them to join my party on the assault on Sven's. But I really feel insistent that I should find... What is this? Now, far away, there is a bridge over a stream. The stream itself is unnamed, but the bridge is widely known as the Troll's Bridge. Move towards the bridge! Okay. Playing battle music. If you want to cross the bridge, you'll have to pay the toll. Or the troll! No? Okay. Tell you what, I'll pay him an axe. I got something to axe you. Yeah, I can attack his hideout now. Loot the monastery in Friese for more money. I could do that. The huge man, huge creature is looking down on you, seemingly unintimidated by your presence or equipment. Ho ho ho, there, what's tripping my bridge? This troll wants some gold because you were on his bridge. You're just a big ugly fool. Oh, crap. Oh, ho, ho. When I was little, my mother said, Grendel, my son, if someone calls you big, ugly, or a fool, ignore him. But if someone calls you all three together, hit him. You're big and ugly. Alright. Here we go. Let's do this. Holy crap! Oh! Okay. I don't think we're gonna win this one. Yep. And I haven't saved in 100 years. So. We just died, but we can reload the game. Okay. Okay, so we didn't lose too much progress, I don't think. Let's check our. Oh, I have to loot it again? Swear words. Alright, let's get the fudge out of here. Let's go. Ugh. Can't believe we have to do that nonsense again. Alright, well, this is why you need to save compulsively. You just need to save all the time. Like, anytime you do anything, you need to save. I did get trolled. I got trolled hard. One swing and he just blew past my shield. That was something right there. Maybe we should try to pay the troll. Loot more monasteries. It is on autosave. This is where it autosaved. Okay, yeah, we know that faction was going to be. I was just so quick in coming back, I guess, that didn't. You're killing me. Drop something nice, though. And honestly, I don't think money is the problem right now. What the problem is that I'm a nobody. Money is not going to solve my being unable to recruit problem. I mean, he charges 500 pennies, but I've got goods worth way more than that. Okay. Here we go. We're going to save again. And we're going to loot this place. Village is a monastery. Everybody needs to follow me because bad things happen when you don't follow me. Seem to have a lot more cavalry. I do need to buy a horse, though. Maybe I do need more money. I need a horse like the deserts need the rain. Drops the only two-hander in the game. Oh, surely there are more two-handers. Surely. Has to be. I just like that his name is Grendel. That's a nice little... Okay, now everyone can charge that we're all here. Alright, come on. Don't run for me like a pussy willow. Okay, he's dead. Fire orders. Hold your fire. I want everyone to be melee right now. Everyone needs to chase down these monks. Not doing so good like I did last time. I killed many a monk last time. Huh. Interesting. I mean, the Irish certainly have to have two-handers. The Galloglasses of this period were well known for having two-handed weapons. And I believe the Pictish also had two-handed swords and such. Surely those towns will have those. Okay, I forgot. Really? I have to do this again. Whatever. Jewelry, hello. Might actually have been much more profitable. Moo? Heck was that? Why would you moo? Okay, let's save the game so we don't have to do that again. My character. And we'll save it again. Okay, I forget what I put it into. I think I put one into tactics and one into leadership. And let's put it all into one hand. Full arms. Okay, done. Save again. And then let's talk to our people in the army. Can't believe it. So noob. We don't actually have anything for you to have. I'd like to ask you something. No. I would like to know about your skills. Am I just blind? Am I just clicking around? Yeah, here we go. Four skills. He is our support character. He does training and tracking. Okay, and one-handed. Done. We can do it again. Oh, attribute point. Charisma. There he goes. mind. Talk to you. Tell me about your skills. She is the surgeon. Dump them all in there. She can't apparently get any more weapon points. Okay, and we're done. Let's save it. Get back the fudge onto our ships. Hopefully it won't happen again. And let's get to this port. You know what? Let's risk it. Let's not repair it this time. Let's repair it at our destination. Sail! There is, I don't know. Okay. Champion two-hander, but you've only seen it in multiplayer. Okay. Alright, Swampy, go for it. So it looks like we're going to lose morale tonight no matter what. We've got plenty of money now for the time being. Here is the worst time for war, yes. Okay. And we sail along the coast. Damage does. Again, the weather. Blah, blah, blah. Can you be my professional singer? Okay. What do you mean by that? Alright, let's see here. Sailing along the coast of Britain, not a big deal. Trying to get to Denmark. Front Ben the Sven the Bull-Neck. Actually, do we have anybody that wants? Nope. Wait. Why are you classified as a horse archer? I don't think he has any. Okay, I'm sorry. I know I'm getting distracted here, but I just gotta see what he's got here. Does he have like horse archery? Power draw. He does have power throw and power draw. I guess they don't have mounted. Unless I'm blind. Done. How do I like the DLC so far? I'm actually enjoying it a lot. The one thing that does have me put off a little bit is that you can die. By which you would just have to reload the save. In order to continue, and so that's causing some issues with me, because I'm used to playing Mountain Blade Warband in kind of Iron Man mode, where if I die and get captured, I just kind of roll with it, and I forget to save, because I just don't save, I accept the consequences of my actions. But here you can just die, and that kind of is silly. So that's really my only complaint so far. I mean, there are obviously, as you're noticing on the stream here, every time the game generates one of these new landing points, it kind of hangs up a little bit. But that's not too bad. I guess I can live with that. But that's the one gameplay decision that has me roiled up is the permadeath. You're going to be the next Nicki Minaj. Okay, let's save the game. We sailed all the way here. Go into port. Alright, and since we probably won't have so much money after I'm done, let's go ahead and see the ships. My boat's flagship. Repair the ship. Okay. So now the ship is in best condition. Any other money that we spend is trade with the locals, trade with the goods merchant. We save that, or not save that, sell it. Sell the chicken that we're not eating. And okay, well, I got 1354 pennings. We're doing pretty good on the pennings front right now, actually. Can I trade with the horse merchant finally? No, even the cheapest horse is still outside my limit. Alright. I'm not gonna sell anything my people are eating, though. That's good for morale. Alright, I guess we take a stroll through town. And go it. Yeah, we take a stroll through town, and we talk to that guy, and get the location of Sven's hideout. But yeah, that's kind of my thoughts of the DLC so far. A lot of people are complaining about the faces and the bodies on the forum, and I don't know why. Because just look at the faces. They're awesome. They're much better than in vanilla. What I would really like to do is to have the team actually backport all the, like, the faces and the lighting schemes and the enhanced graphics into the native module, because that will definitely breathe more life into that. I was at there, I have the book. Take it now, we're Sven's hideout. Okay. Quest completed. Farewell. Okay, and I think that's all we're gonna do. Let's just see if we can buy better equipment anyway. Let's trade with the locals some more. The armorer is someone we need. We have just tunics right now. And that's kind of bad. Women's tunic. No. Sturdy short gambeson. Still, even the worst armor. Cracked Norse helm. 25 to head armor. You know what? I'm probably just going to save my money at this point. Save it for men. So let's go ahead and leave. Now, let's go ahead and save the game. I'm going to make a bad decision here, everyone. I'm going to go straight for Sven's hideout. Just to do it. Are you grading this end of term? I am. Well, I actually finished my grading last time. Legal action. Or not last time, but yesterday. On the banks of a river, you distinguish a Viking fort, and you found the hideout of Sven. It's a good place with a small port of ships, easy to defend. Behind the wall between the houses, you can see some warriors. You cannot count them without being seen, but it seems there are a few dozen of them in there. In the middle of the fort, you see some prisoners prepared for sale. Could your mother be among them? I need to recruit more men. Okay. We know this guy will deal with us if we give him money, so let's go ahead over to this village and give him money. Maybe the random number generator will be kind to us and give us, like, a dozen more men. Want to go to the village center. Get out weapons in case things go bad. Oh, man. This hideout has like 30 men. Okay. Yeah, my men, except for the cavalry, are all pretty newbie. So I would rather want to attack with a pretty much a full party and then hope. I am recruiting. Of course, your time and help will be rewarded. Beg, I think I've been wasting my time. Farewell. Oh, shoot. Okay. Well, I fudged that up. Scourge, scourge, scourge. Scourge, you derp. Alright, well, let's go bribe the village leader of another village. I'm going to accept that as part of doing business. Request a meeting and duel him. Okay, that sounds interesting. Okay, well, let's go to the village center. and recruit. See if we can bribe any recruits here. Well, saith Ether, welcome to the stream. Local leader, I am recruiting. For men, let's see. There's 500 pennings. Okay. From this moment on, you may recruit in this village. Okie doke. Recruit volunteers. 4 freedmen want to follow me. Recruit them. Okay. Eve. Alright, let's keep an eye on our dash here, and let's go to Bull's Hath here. And let's just get a few more men just in case the duel goes bad. My troops suck. Oh, ooh, it's gonna be night. The fort. Roll the grounds. Young warrior, herdman. Something tells me that won't be able to recruit here. I need to relearn all the graphics for the forts and things. Alright, let's just get out of here. Let's go to Sven's hideout. Maybe we'll do a surprise attack option. I like to stream things people haven't seen before. Just so you know. So when people are like, let's duel them. Well, that usually means that you've done it yourself. So why watch a stream of something you've already done when we can take a different action? That's my philosophy. Well, let's save it. Now we're going to game this a little bit. Go to Sven's hideout. Sven's hideout. It's late at night. Your men need some rest. Early morning. Surprise attack. Okay. Battle advantage is 3. Everyone needs to follow me. And everyone needs to hold fire. I want you to be melee. Oh, crap. Alright, come on. Gang up on him. Yeah, that's right. You got him. There's no way I'll be able to hit him in there. These guys are tough. The enemy has lost a leader. Their troops panic. Alright. Well, okay. Everybody can charge now. I like... They are using formations. That's pretty cool. Come on. We're flanking this. Stab him in the face. Stab him in the face. Alright. Wow. These guys are... Guys are falling pretty. Okay, we're starting to lose some. We lost one guy. One guy killed. There we go. I haven't killed anyone myself yet. Because the melee is just so... Okay. Alright. Who's getting kicked? Oh wow, we took the camp. You want troops you should have, don't you? Yes. I did defend the village. Your casualties. Got 2 wounded. 1 seriously wounded, 1 minor wounded. Brunhild was 1 wounded. 1 killed or seriously wounded, 4 minor wounded. Okay, so I didn't actually lose anyone because they were all wounded. Enemy casualties. 9 killed, 1 Danish League Viking killed, Harold was wounded. Injuries none. Continue. After a tough battle, your men have defeated the Vikings protecting the hideout. In one of the houses, you find 3 prisoners, 2 women and 1 man. The women are unknown to you, perhaps prisoners from other Viking raids, but the man is Bodo, the Cantabrian who traveled with you on the Woden Rick. Bodo joins your party. An old friend is back. He asks you to walk away with him. He wants to tell you what happened after Sven Bull-Neck's attack on the Woden Rick. But first, you need to decide what to do with Sven's hideout. I really don't care for the hideout, so I order my men to pillage and destroy it. Pillage and destroy it. There we go. I got 3,000 pennings. We gained 10 morale, 14 renown, 200 experience. Nice. I have things to tell you. Listen carefully. Tell me what happened since the Woden Reek was attacked by Sven Bull-Neck. Is my mother still alive? I should be dead, but I still live when others who should be alive are dead. I came to consider the ship, the Woden Rick, who brought me to the north as a home, and its crew as my family. So when the Vikings attacked, I grabbed my sword and my shield and prepared to defend my family to the death. The Cantabrians are Christians, but some of us still remember the old gods. One in particular, Erudino, guides us in battle, and I shout his name while attacking with my sword. Okay. I'm not an idiot. I knew that the battle was lost. We were outnumbered, and they were better armed, but I asked Erudino to let me kill as many as possible before my trip to paradise. And maybe my sacrifice would have allowed the others to flee or cause fear in the Vikings. But these Vikings were hardened men who knew their job well. Half a dozen of them surrounded me and beat me while their companions invaded the Woden Rick and killed whoever stood in their way. Okay, but what about my mother? I saw everyone down, the captain, the sailors, the archers that protected the boat, and I thought I myself was dead until I woke up in the Viking ship, tied hand and foot. I was a prisoner, but thank God I have escaped. I'm a miserable man before Erudino. Now I should be dead and the others alive. Now I just live for redemption. Bodo, did anyone else survive the Viking attack? I know you only want to ask if your mother is still alive and where she is. Well, I have not told you everything. I need you to stay calm. Listen to me carefully. I'm not sure I want to hear what you'll say. I understand, my friend, but you must know everything. Put his hand on your shoulder and smile sadly. Sven Bull-Neck didn't end up there by chance. Our boat was his goal, and we had a traitor on board. Okay, what are you saying? What purpose? What traitor? Steps back, takes a deep breath, and looks you in the eyes. What happened was my fault, Crawmerax. I was Sven Bull-Neck's target, so we were attacked, and so on. And I commended my soul to Erudino. I was willing to die, but the Vikings wanted me alive, and that is my fault, as I brought death to my family on the boat. My redemption is that Sven Bull-Neck will die at my hands. No, Sven Bull-Neck is mine, and I'll kill you if you cross my path. Oh, gosh. Are you responsible for what happened? After Sven, you shall pay with your life? Justice? Man, choices. I'll wait for the delay. Any feedback there, audience? What should I do here? Should I say that... I don't know if this is actually a choice, probably. Maybe I should... I'll wait for at least some comment. Got Fight Guy with Warts, welcome, and Lord Zero, welcome as well. Kalo the Dark, welcome. XXDXX9, welcome. So you were the traitor. Okay, be friends, don't hate on him. Okay. Number 3. I think we have a lot of people that would like a more friendly response, so... There you go. The relation with Bodo has deteriorated. Well, great. Sighs with annoyance. You're not listening to me. I was Sven's target. How can I betray myself? I was stupid. I believed that the Woden Rick was safe, but I was wrong. I was betrayed by its captain. The poor man thought Sven Bull-Neck would give him wealth. He was cheated, for when the Vikings raided the Woden Rick, he was killed. Maybe some things become clear now, like why we stopped among those shipwrecks, and why the captain of the Woden Rick gave control of the ship to you, a novice among us. The Woden Rick captain had betrayed me, indeed all of us, but I do not begrudge him. He was just an idiot, and this cost him his life. But why was Sven Bull-Neck chasing you? Why were you his goal? Oh, so many things! But he is frickin' lucky to be dead. He shrugs. Little beak can be done in this regard. Okay, I was Sven Bull-Neck's target as I had something very important in my hands. Something so important that his lord, Sigurd Ragnarsson, would kill for it. But I did something terrible before the Viking assault. And so far I have asked you to stay calm. I did something I regret. Oh, crap. He gave it to my mom, whatever it was. Yep, I gave it. I totally called it. I gave it to your mother. I thought that it was safer in her hands than in mine. Before your justified anger against me causes any fatal action, you should know that it saved her life, because the Vikings thought she was my master. You understand? If not for that object, she probably would be dead now, like the rest of the people on the Woden Rick. Your mother's disease helped too, because the Vikings think that madness is a touch of the gods. Sven took your mother north with him and left me to my fate here, to be sold as a slave because he thought she was my master and the object carrier. We must hurry, because when Sven Bull-Neck discovers the truth, he will kill her. Who are you really, and what is so important to be wanted by Sven and his lord? Kalo the Dark, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. I'm looking at chat. Oh, well, I never got out of the conversation, being in the negatives in relationship. Hashtag no honor. Welcome, Trooper Jim. Bodo likes being submissive. Okay. Wow, 600 experience. That's not important, but I will tell you that I'm not a common traveler. I was sent by the King of Asturias, and what I brought with me was a gift that could change the course of a war. We'll talk about this later. It is urgent now to find your mother. Sven Bull-Neck was summoned by his lord. Sigurd wants this object and will interrogate your mother about it because he thinks she has the information he needs. We must find Sigurd soon. Fate is written with blood and steel, and my redemption weaves through them both. Irodino has answered my prayers, bringing you to me. You will not find a more loyal companion or closer friend. You gain 10 renown. Grab your thing. We've lots to do. Good. Give me a few moments to prepare, and I'll be ready to move. Fate is playing with you. First, everything was pointing to your mother's death. You were driven partly by the need to survive, but mainly by revenge. Find Sven Bull-Neck and kill him. But now that your mother is still alive and in the hands of your enemies, your priority is to find and rescue her. Go, go! Okay. Your party gains 2 morale. Some soldiers are ready to upgrade. Alright, let's save the game. And now let's upgrade our soldiers. I want to upgrade my horsemen. I got peasant woman. When did I get a peasant woman? Huh. Alright, Bodo and Brunhild. Okay, talk. Oh, can you tell me about your skills? Alright, she is the surgeon person. Wound treatment. Can't do any fighting, really. Never mind. Bodo, talk. To say about your skills. Skill point 6. What is his natural inclination here? Power strike and power throw. And good athletics. He's also a good trainer, it turns out. Darn it, we already were specking someone else in that, but whatever. Let's see. What would he be good at? I could dump a bunch of stuff into spotting. They don't have anyone that does that. I'd like to kind of customize. So now, any warrior character needs iron flesh to be maxed out. Okay, so he's going to have lots of hit points. He is definitely a born warrior. I don't know why I just put two-handed weapons. We just talked about how there aren't any. But I am going to... There we go. Never mind. And we got some monks we need to sell as well. Okay, so that was all good party management. Let's save the game. Let's see if we can recruit more people. Okay, as you stop to rest on the way, your companions approach you, led by Brunhild. She has something to say. Alright. My lord, Sven's hideout was a dangerous place, but we managed to ransom Bodo. I understand you want to find your mother, but let me tell you, when I was in the court of the Jarl of Kenimer, I heard horrible things about Sigurd. Sigurd's snake in the eye was in the meat hall of the Jarl of Kenimer on more than one occasion. He is not just any man, my lord. You know that Jarl of Kenimer is a hard man, but he trembled before Sigurd. Sigurd doesn't say a lot, he never smiles, and his snake eyes burrow into you as if you were trying to read your thoughts. I was but a slave, but I heard things. People say that he is the most dangerous of the sons of Ragnar. A man who would kill you just for coughing nearby or for being in his way on the wrong day. The beautiful Brunhild's right, Crawmerax. From what I know, Sigurd Ragnarsson is a kind of man that anyone should stay away from. Unfortunately, he is in our way. I don't believe it is so bad, Raginhard says, because he is raging hard. Quack and Lord Zero, thank you so much for the follow. Ah, the women are the captives of the camp you saved. Good job, W. Mellon. I was missing that detail. see. I don't believe it is so bad. You don't trust the Jarl of Kenimer, since he is an accomplished actor who uses every possible tool to try to manipulate others. If he saw an advantage in passing as timid before Sigurd, he would have done that. I'd be very careful with him, as he's a man who smiles when you face him and stabs you with a dagger when you turn. With Sigurd, at least, you always know where he is coming from. Raginhard is talking out of his arse. I have heard things. I have seen Sigurd when he was drinking or betraying someone. Sigurd is spiteful, never forgiving. He never forgets. You have the gall, woman, to call me a drunken traitor to my face? Well, Raginhard, you are kind of a drunk. And a traitor. Anyway, you know nothing about me. Watch your words or you will have to watch your back. Oh, so this is going to be like one of those companion things where I gotta try to... Okay, Bodo, can you give me some advice about Sigurd? Ah, you gotta be kidding me. They think I am... all of us think that we are a weak leader. Well, gosh darn it. We are at crossroads. Sigurd's snake in the eye has what we need, and your mother's life is in danger. In my opinion, we should go and talk to him, even if it costs our lives. We have no choice. Maybe there is another way. There is a powerful man who hates Sigurd. King Horik Godfredson of Danmark, Sigurd's lord. What does he do to hate him? Well, I know only what I've heard. They are enemies. Maybe Sigurd wants to be king himself. Sigurd would be stupid then. King Horik could banish him, make him an outcast, and strip him of his lands. Denouncing him in the assembly of the slightest infraction. My knowledge is limited, but perhaps Sigurd is as powerful as the king himself. Or perhaps maybe King Horik doesn't want more wars in Denmark after getting his throne after a long war with the other Jarls. Speak with Sigurd to tell King Horik we have a difficult decision. What is this thing you speak of? The thing, or the assembly, is a meeting of free men where disputes are solved and political decisions are made. Okay. I think we should get the protection and support of King Horik. This will give us an advantage when talking to Sigurd, and will force us to respect our lives. If King Horik helps us, you can legally claim your mother back. Do not go straight to Sigurd's snake in the eye now. It may cause the death of your mother, and perhaps you will lose track of Sven Bull-Neck forever. And there is no guarantee that King Horik will support us. If I have to choose between going straight to Sigurd and getting killed or going to Horik and getting your mother killed, I wouldn't know what to say. But you got me out of the hole where I was, so I'm fine with your choice, whatever it is. Thank you, Raginhard. I need to think about it. Thank you all. We have to continue our travels. Okay. Sozels. We've got a decision, I guess. Go to the village center. Oh, I can't recruit people here anymore, right? For the day. Which, seriously. Uzi Monkey, how you doing? Alright. Can we try to recruit here, perhaps, and we'll staff? Where would the King of Denmark be, anyway? Probably not down here. Let's see. Visit the Lord's Hall. Spearman. Odin Priest. Well, that's just fine and dandy, like sour candy. Alright, King of Denmark. Jarl Sigurd Ragnarsson. Okay, yeah, he's got 222 men. So... I probably don't want to confront him. Just saying. While your party rests to recover from the fatigue of the road, you take advantage to get away a bit from the camp and have some privacy, as you have an upset stomach. but your relaxation, hidden among some rocks, is disturbed by a noise to your right. Quickly dress and take up your weapon. Alright, so we're getting assaulted, apparently. Stranger shouts, quick! Back to camp. We're in danger. Okay. One attacker yells, who are you, woman? Anyway, you're too late. Crawmerax, the Jarl of Kenimer, wants your head. You're a fool to walk whatever. Alright, so basically this is an assassination attempt by the Jarl of Kenimer. Where is he? Oh crap, who the fudge are you? Solveig! Hired assassin is killed. Whoa! Oop! Ow! Alright, guy. You're... Ow! Okay, there's a lot of them, and I don't see where the other one is. Alright, buddy. Alright, axe time! Ow! Ouch! I might get walloped right here. Okay. Hi, guy. How you doing? All right. Finish Archer. Ow. I got lots of wounds in my body. Okay. Oh, I beat them off. Who is Selvig? Oh, well. Alright, well, let's save. I don't want to have to do that again. Idabai. Probably eating a Danish. Check your quests. Ah, yes. Sorry, I took my eyes off a chat because I was being assaulted. You know how it is. I need to get permission, that's right. Go to the village center. Then take on some masterless men. That's what we need to do. Oh, welcome. I just saw my view count jumped up. Welcome, everybody. Boy, that's a huge view count jump up by about 10 people. I try to greet people as they come in, but I was fighting for my life, as you know. Welcome, everyone, to the stream. I appreciate your viewership. Local leader. I am recruiting. Interesting. You're looking for men and I, by coincidence? No people in the area? What can I say? I see what you're trying to say, old man. Here's 500 gold. I can recruit here. Okay. Let's recruit some volunteers. 6 freedmen want to follow me. Recruit them. Okay, leave. Alright, we're almost at, what's my party maximum? Army. Party maximum is 72. Okay. And I can level up. So let's go ahead and do that. No attribute points yet. I've leveled up 5 times now. No attribute points. That's kind of disturbing. I probably don't need leadership right now. I got 72 men. I mean, come on. I don't need that right now. Sea King. For every point, increase the maximum number of ships. Navigation, power strike is something I need. Pathfinding is nice as well. Pole arms. I will use a pole arm eventually when I get a horse. Alright. I also need to sell some people. Don't get too many troops. Your starship can only carry so much. This is true. But everything we need here... Everything we need right now is actually in Denmark, so I'm not too concerned about being able to travel across the ocean just yet. I'm going to go to Riba, see if we can get get any armor, any body armor. Let's see. Is this the king? No, Kunigur Horgwick is here, though. Uh-oh. Ooh, I thought it had... Okay, there's a tournament here. Let's go ahead and save the game. And let's join the tournament and try to get invited to an audience with King Horik here. And Jarl Sigurd is also here for the competitions. Let us join the competitions. Place a bet on myself. 100 pennings. Go ahead. Fight in the round. Alright, I am bonered again with having a weapon that can't block, but... Ow! Ow. Alright. Stabby, stabby! Stabby, stabby! Alright. Awesome. Victory is yours. You have won this melee, but now you must prepare yourself for the next round. Place a bet on myself. The maximum bet. Could have made that your home. I didn't want to have it. Yeah, I just didn't want to have it. Fight in the next round. All right, I got a weapon I can block with, at least. Stay with my dudes. Ow! All right. I fight better with these kinds of weapons when I don't have a shield open. Ow! That did hurt. Oh boy, I'm gonna get bangered. Why was everyone else on my team incompetent? Alright, shield out. Yeah, I'm bonered. Well, there went, as the only man to remain, King Horik. Alright, so that scheme to get into his audience has failed. That was fun. Visit the Lord's Hall. Jarl, what's his doofus? The king! Do I know you? I am Crawmerax. Well, I am King Horik Gottfriedson, the ruler of the Kingdom of Denmark and the Lord of Riba. Your fame runs before you. Perhaps it is time that you sought a liege worthy of your valor. Alright, cool. I wish to welcome you to my hall on this auspicious occasion. Now, what is it? I could game it. But just by competing, it looks like I was invited to the feast. So, I'm gonna accept that. Let's see, I would ask permission to recruit men in your land. I'm from Friese. I would like to ask permission... What? Okay, an important issue. You have my interest, I am listening to you. Talk about Sigurd. Oop, Sigurd regularly runs my jarls, we have nothing to talk about, you understand? Okay, are we finished, or do you need something else? How about let's do a task for him now? Let's check what my journal says. Let's see. It's Sven's hideout. You find Bodo. Yeah. Let's see. It seems you will not have any help from the king. You'll have to talk to Jarl Sigurd Ragnarsson directly. Gosh darn it! Before you place your hands. So I goofed that up. I think. Alright, I am gonna game it. I didn't think it was like a once-in-a-lifetime thing. We're not gonna fight in the tournament. I refuse to do that. I am just gonna visit the Lord's Hall. I guess we'll just have to pretend. All these jarls here. Kunigur, hi. Do you have any tasks for me? Let's go ahead. I need to deliver a letter to Ealdorman Oswald of King of East Ingle. We must be at Hagelison urgently currently. If you are going towards there, Would you deliver the letter? Certainly. Oh, no. I have to go on the ocean. Well, fudge. Yeah, I doubt I'll be seeing him anytime soon. Oh, gosh darn it. Okay. Oh. I am stymied. I have no need for anybody. Sorry I didn't read that out loud. It was just... Let's see. If you had enough of a renown, he would listen to me. Okay. Alright, well... Then let's game it. Join the competitions. I'm just gonna fight in the next round. I'm not gonna place a bet on myself. See, it looks like we have a spear this time. At least I have a weapon that does damage when I poke it at people. Okay. Ow, ow, ow. Ow, ow, ow. Ow, ow, ow. Okay, there goes... I hate the... Oh, come on, gang! You've been bested in melee, but the Master of Ceremonies declares a recognition of your skill and bravery, allowing me to continue. Alright, fight in the next round. Hate getting dongered with all these stupid... numbnutses. At least I have a decent weapon this time. Ow. Alright, I killed one guy. Well, this time I was on the good team. victory is yours. I've won the melee. Fight in the next round. Okay. Only got two people. I have a crap weapon. But I can pick up this guy's sword if I kill him. I really dislike that kicking animation. I really prefer the Floris mods. Ow! Dang it, misread him. It's one thing I don't like about the vanilla tournament system is they... Not the round shield. Common sword. Come on, common sword. There we go. Now I have a weapon that can block and reach. Alright, buddy. Come on. Alright, that was a stab in the face. There we go. There we go. Victory is mine! Fight in the next round. Okay, we've got a potential to be dongered here. I do lose relationship, but you will cover it later. Well, the dialogue option disappeared. Alright. It looks like we gotta... Okay. I might still pull through. Okay. I probably won't. Oh, I still might. Serpentine! Ouch. Ow. All right, come on. Oh, rats. I did well there. But I am able to advance, so let's go. I do not know that. No spoilers on the stream. If it is bugged out, then we'll just do sandbox for a while. Ah, crap. Donger, 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 donger. I do hate getting clip dongered. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Come on. Don't clip through each other. That is. They need to fix that. They need to fix that. I really dislike that. He looks like Alistair from Dragon Age Origins. Okay, so I need to find other ways of getting more renown. Alright, I need to find more ways of getting renown. I dislike that. Hire more men. Oh. Where's all the bandits and shit? Friese was covered in bandits. Maybe we need to go north. Let's save the game. Pagan priests, I don't really much care for you. Priests, my men need Odin. I will donate 200 paintings for your aid in this matter. Oh. Let's see what this does. I'll talk to your men about Odin, Thor, and Freya. It will encourage them to proudly fight by your side and return to seats in Valhalla. Counter pagan priests. You have 39 troops fit for battle against their 11? Okay. I will gain one renown if I win. Dokel. Also, everyone needs to hold their fire. Hold your fire. I want everyone to be a melee on this one. Something tells me this isn't going to go as smoothly as I think it will. They're just priests, right? I had at least 200 when you talked to him. Okay. Okay, so they're going to do the... gonna do the thing where they stand on a hill. It's fine. All right, let me change my fire orders. Let's see. Fire at will. Come on. Valhalla. Yeah, they're doing the Germanic spellings. Alright, everyone can charge. Okay. I don't understand how paying them 200 denars started a battle, but... Where's my cavalry? Cavalry charge. No. Cavalry charge. Everybody needs to charge. Why are we not charging? You should be... right. Because they're archers, apparently. Alright, there they go. Everyone needs to charge. I appreciate that they have new formations now, but we need everybody charging after them. They're just gonna get away. They're just gonna get away. I don't want them to. Demand, welcome. Script error. Mission temperate lead charge trigger. Hey, you defeated the enemy. I have no casualties. Battle's over. What do you want to do with the loot? Order to share the loot like it is common. And we can just kind of sell this stuff because it's useless. Warlord, Brunhilde is the most insolent girl. I have tried to be polite, even friendly, only to have her rebuff me. The little thing thinks she is already a warrior and not only a camp slave. As we are cleaning our weapons after the last battle, I remarked that I thought her a handsome girl and I would happily find her a match with one of my friends. I explained to her that even though I am looking for a wife, I would only marry a free woman. I thought it was a very generous offer, as an army slave is hardly going to find herself awash in prospects. But rather than thank me, she simply turned her back without a word. It was only out of respect for your leadership that I not immediately try to teach her some manners. I really think you should discipline your slaves better. Okay. No. Brunhilde has my support. Okay. That was crazy. She is a daughter of my friend in Dachinga. We are not going to get on odds with that, our friend in Dachinga. Alright, so renown. Let's check our character. How much renown do we have? 186. So the breaking point must be around 200 then. Reputation is noble. I can read. Scars, none. Okay. So we only need a little bit more renown before we can speak to him. Maybe I can do a quest for the guildmaster in Reba. And that will get me renown. Alright. I should have saved after that last battle. I'm not sure why I didn't. Let's go ahead and save it here. And now go back. I doubt anyone's going to be out. It's frickin' night all the time. Is it just me, or is it always night in this game? Dawn. Okay. Stroll through town. Is there still a tournament here? I would join again, but I get dongered all the time by clipping issues and having a weapon that doesn't block. Halvard. Oh, stranger, you seem to be new to Reba. I am the mayor of a town. You have a job for me, buddy. Let's see. Undertaking a group of bandits have kidnapped the daughter of a friend of mine. Oh, I love this mission. My friend is ready to pay them, but he will still need someone to take the money of those rascals. One of bandits is wrath in the okay. You have 15 days to take the money. We'll be waiting near the village of Agderby. Those bastards said that they're going to kill the poor girl if they don't get the money by that time. You'll get your pay of 290 pennies when you bring the girl back safely here. Alright, I'll take the ransom money and bring the girl back. Okay. Let's leave. I love this mission, and it does pay pretty well, because we attack the bandits and get to keep the ransom money. But where is this village? I don't see it. Ransom girl from bandits. And goodbye, show on map. You gotta be shitting me. Okie doke. Up north we go. Might have to disband some people. Bill from the port. I have not enough room. Let's see the ships. Price, way too much than I can afford. Way too much. Okay, back. Steve, gotta manage my army. Alright, so peasant women, disband. Ooh. Let's upgrade you to a horse person. Let's disband those guys. So that's 4. I need to disband 8 more people. So here we go. Let us sail from the port. Actually, let us save the game. Yep. So that is something that I would rather, you know, why? Okay. Why does it have to be so freaking far? Alright, so here we go. Severe weather has damaged my ship. Still haven't sold my prisoners yet either. Okay, come on, keep going. There a port I can dock at? Yes, let's dock at the port. That's easier to keep tabs on. Landing point. I have heard that your boats can be stolen from landing points, so I'm going to go ahead and make sure everything's at a port. Okay, and we are in port now. Okay, with the locals. Don't we have stuff I can sell? Yes, we do. Burp, burp. Rotten chicken, we can get rid of that. Cling. Okay. So I save you a few thousand. Build a ship when you can. It's slightly cheaper. Save you a few thousand. Okay, we will do that. Alright, so the girl is going to be over here somewhere. Only carry so many people. So we're going to have to disband another person, probably. I need to sell these slaves. I bet the slaves or the monks that I've been carrying around since forever is what's holding me back. Okay, day's training is complete. Hooray! 7/6/10 and welcome to the stream. I just saw that my viewer count jumped up by a fair bit. Welcome, everybody. We are trying to get renown so that we can convince the king of Denmark to let us talk about a jarl so that we can get our mother back legally because, you know, mommy. And there's the bandits awaiting ransom. Save. Let us go. Alright, are you the one that brought the ransom? Quick, give us the money now. No way, you release the girl first. You fool, stop playing games and give us the money. I have no intention of paying you anything. I demand that you release the girl now. You won't be demanding anything when you're dead. I love this mission. Start battle holding position. I think they're going to charge us. I can gain 7 renown if we win. Actually, I want you guys to follow me. And, let's see if they charge us. Where are they? Seriously. Kind of a weird battlefield. I guess we're gonna have to go towards them. Used to be the AI would charge all the time. I guess we're gonna go walking up this hill. I need to buy that frickin' horse. Before I buy a new ship, I need to buy a horse. Supplies are needed if you're building a high-tier ship. Eptica, thank you so much for the follow! I need tar to build a ship, which I could never find. Okay. Yeah, selling prisoners will get me fast moolah. I need to remember to do that. Okay, where are they? Everybody charge. Because they have keen knowledge of where the enemy is. Okay, so the enemy is this way. Everybody follow me. I like how my men just always know where the enemy is. Where's the battle music? I kind of miss it. Surely if I come up on this hill here, be able to see the enemy deployed in what is apparently probably their formation. Alright. There they are. Yep. Okay, everybody. Looks like this is their, I kind of like how the AI finally uses formations now. The time when they charged was just, you know, or rather the charges they would do all the time are kind of silly. Alright, and I'm going to throw rocks at them. Let's pelt. It doesn't look like they have archers of their own, so let's just have our men pelt them for a while. They look more equipped than my men are, so that javelin just gets stuck in that tree. These trees are some of the most flexible trees I've ever seen. It looks like my horsemen have already given away all their stuff. Alright. What I want everyone to do now is hold your fire, and I want everyone to charge. Okay, here we go. Alright, axe time! And my men are already dying, that is not good. Okay, come on. Ooh. We are taking some bosses here. And let me swing my axe. Why do their weapons get to clip, but mine gets stuck? We have lost a quarter of our men in a short time. Alright, I killed some guys. Oh, I lost a lot, but we won. That's the important thing. Battle 1, your foes lie slaughtered. Let's see. Your casualties. 2 freedmen were killed. Brunhild was wounded. My Frasina, 7 kills. So I got 9 killed. Total 9 killed and 1 wounded. Dang, yo. Oh, sir, thank you so much for rescuing me. Will you take me to my family out now? Yes, we are going home. And we captured some footpads. Shall now also be a horseman. Okay. Done. Order to share the loot. Ooh, sturdy boots. Finally, some real armor. Let's see. Crude rawhide shield. Is this better than what I've got? Nope. Chipped big axe. Big axe. Nope. Any clothing? Better than what I have. Quality Phrygian. Nope. Everything's terrible. Excellent. Actually, what I need to do is I need to equip my followers. Oh, wow. A lot of loot here. Grab everything. Wow. 422 pennings. Some soldiers ready. Sir, since I have joined your shield wall, I have tried hard to learn how to live like a soldier, which is much better than being a slave. And how to honor the warrior's code, but some of your men do not respect me as an equal. After our last victory, I was picking through the slain, and the Frisian called Ragenhard pushed me aside, saying that looting was no job for a simple slave girl that was just allowed to travel with the army. I believe that if I battle alongside the shield wall, I deserve my share of the loot just like any other warrior, even though I might be less experienced than the others. I also risk my life. Need you finally charge. Yeah. Okay. Alright, well, let's see here. Ragenhard is a valuable member of this company. I don't want you picking any fights with him. Tell Ragenhard you have my support in this. Gosh dang it, folks. Why can't we just get along? Also become a horse person. You're faster. And better in every way. Alright, kidnap girl, monk, footpad. Okay, so I do need to do some management here. Let's save the game in case I've had it crash on these screens here, so let's talk to Ragenhard and let him see his equipment. Boots. Quality dark boots. 20 leg armor, so he's already got that handled. A light long spear. Well, how about a crude round shield, sir? There, now you can be a real shield warrior. And how about a chipped big axe? In case you run into troubles. Okay, return. Never mind. Brunhild, let's talk. Your equipment. Let's see, she's got boots all ready. Crude rawhide shield. Rusty long axe. Let's put her, give her a hat. She has some head armor. Anything else? She has a woman's short tunic. I don't think any of this stuff is better than what she's got. Nope. Hunting knife. Yeah, whatever. Okay. Mind. Bodo, let's talk to you. Let's see your equipment. Got different kinds of spear. Let's give you a shield. You also have... Let's give you a hat. Bonk. And give you an axe as well, so that you can defend yourself in melee. Alright. That looks like everybody's got things that we... At least the latest in Viking gear. Go to Tunsberg. Tunsberg. Welcome to the city of Townsberg. Wait, isn't it Townsville? Rats, it was Townsville. That's right, Melon. I believe in equality. When I tell someone off, I give them candy. And Tetra and Rorlimar, welcome. And also, thank you for the follow. Who just followed me? I need to do some chat backtracking here. Eptica, thank you for the follow. Sounds about right. Yes. Okay. Hunsberg. Maybe we can sell some equipment. Maybe sell the prisoners. Get some money. Get some actual equipment. I would really like a Viking sword. That would be great. Okay, trade with the locals. Goods merchant. Sell, sell, sell. All these weapons and things suck. He has 1,900 pennings. Gotta be careful, we might get there. Okay. So not trade with the goods merchant. We already tapped him out. Trade with the horse merchant. Because the horse merchant would be interested in these things. I could buy a pony. Or I could buy a horse. I could buy a pony. Talk with the armorer. Short Gambeson. I could actually afford this now. Let's actually trick out my character before we buy a mount. See, Tattern Gambeson. All this stuff is... Okay, I can buy this. Get rid of that. Cracked Norse helm. Buy that. Not gonna get too quality equipment right now. Let's see. I need gloves of any kind. Hardened gloves, that's good. Let's see, what else? Are there any better boots? I've got sturdy boots already. Doesn't look like there's going to be any better boots. Ooh, sturdy wrapping shoes. Alright. Sturdy wrapping shoes. Alright, so I'm looking more and more like a Viking now. Return. And let's see, trade with the weaponsmith. Let's see what we can get here. A balanced sword for a huge amount of money. Oh, man. Okay, doesn't look like we can really get anything. Yeah. Nothing that's better than what I've got. Oh well. I really would like a sword. Sword and an axe. That's my usual combo anyway. Okay, so we've got better everything. We upgraded everything. I look like I might be able to actually fight. Sail from the port. Oh no, well, we can probably sell we can probably sell the Huzits, the prisoners, when we get to Denmark. Also, let's save the game. So we don't have to do all that again. Right. That ugly is that armor is ugly. Could you please help my pony? Yeah. Pony is okay. Sail this way now. This slave trader. Can I talk to him? Or will this start a battle? Let's save. I would like to talk to the slave trader. Good day, my lord. We're trading slaves in the port. In the port of Tunsburg. Okay, that's very well. That's all I wanted to know. Darn it. I really just wanted to trade with him on at the sea. Okay, gotta look for the box. There we go. Alright, we are in port. Thank you so much for bringing me back. I can't wait to see my family. Farewell. Kidnapped girls left the party. Alright. Stroll through town. Let's talk with the guy and get our fee. I don't know. It looks fairly authentic, this Gambesian. Alright. Where is the dude? Where is he? I messed this up. There he is. I think that's where he is. You should sell your slaves. I know! Oh, Sweden? Yeah, no Sweden! Alvard! Good day, Crawmerax. I got 3 renown! I'm in your debt for bringing back my friend's daughter. Please take these 290 pennies that I promised you. My friend wished he could be more, but paying that ransom brought him to his knees. I have the ransom. Na-na-na-na-na. You have a job for me. Well, you look able enough. I think I might have something you could do. Got some fighting in your town lately with all the chaos that comes with it. Upsetting locals to try to make their fortune out of looting the shops and farms. A lot of the valuable goods were taken, and somebody teach those bastards a lesson. So I'm like, yeah, I'll do it. Excellent. You'll find the looters roaming around the countryside, probably trying to rob more good people. Kill or capture the bastards. I don't care what you do with them. I'll pay you a bounty of 40 pennies on every band of looters you destroy until all the looters are dealt with. Awesome! Okay, so let's go find a slave trader. Now, in the last town we were at that was like this, the slave trader was on the docks, so let's go to the docks and find the slave trader. How did I get armored? I bought it. I bought the armor. Bought the armor. Okay, there's a slave trader, I think, right over there. I'm not going to grind too much. I already had 186 out of the 200 that you seem to indicate was the breaking point. So, really, after this quest, we should be good to continue the storyline. Slave trader. I brought some prisoners. Sell, sell, sell. Footpad. Sell, sell. Okay. All the prisoners are sold. Pleasure doing business with you. Yes, I'm sure it was. Okay. So we need to track loot down looters now. These guys.
How dare you live from
okay,
him?
You caught me in a good mood. You'll have nothing but cold steel, scum. Charge the enemy! I've lost a lot of men. Or rather, everyone follow me. Seeing as the AI is starting to use formations now. Okay. I don't know which shield I prefer. Where are they? Men, we're moving towards them. Right, got them. Move your companion to the top of your army. Vorathian, welcome! Yeah, we'll do some party management after this. I have been neglectful in that. Okay. There they are. Charge! Ah, see, there's their lead. I think that's their leader right there. That's just standing off to the side. So I think all the armies spawn with leaders now, as Uzi Monkey pointed out. So let's kill this guy that's mysteriously off on his own, and then see what happens. Hello! I received 2 damage, oh noes! Alright. Knocked unconscious. Okay, everyone can charge now. And everyone needs to hold their fire. Charge. Okay. Yep. Ruffian, ruffian, ruffian. All them, there's all dyin's. Okay, that was quick and easy. That was an easy mission. Okay, continue. Let's share the loot. Boots and tunics and bustabulas and crude shoes. We don't actually need any of this stuff for my companions. We're just gonna sell it. Okay, 216 experience sold. Alright, was that not the... Deal with looters. The mayor has to deal with the looters in the surrounding countryside. Is that not all of them? Crap. Okay. Where could the extra looters be? Well, they're apparently not in this direction. I'm not even finding tracks. I need to zoom in a little bit here. Big tracks of that big war party. There's our tracks. They were... We did. They were marked in blue, I thought. Okay. They're big party tracks here. We're not going to find them at night, of course. Press backspace for the minimap. Ah, yes. That's the key. Okay, winter is worse. Okay, and we paid our troops. Okay, it's late night. Okay, let's go actually just go to this village here. And maybe they'll have a quest that I can actually... Ooh, here we go. This will give me some renown. The village infested by 18 footpads, so let's attack the bandits. We'll save the town. Reinforcements have arrived. Now let me through, let me through. I'm gonna beat up them bandits and save the town. Slayer Bambi, no friendly, welcome. Those are Daisy-related names if I've ever seen them. Here we go. This is what they like to do. They like to charge and mill about. Okay. Everyone hold fire and everyone charge. That way we run them all down. How dare you? got him right across the face. You probably couldn't see that because that horse was in the way, but I got him right across the face. That was awesome. It is very difficult to get experience by killing things when you don't have that horse. I really should have bought that horse. Okay. So we've freed the village, and we lost 3 farmers. In a battle worthy of song, you and your men drive the bandits out. Refuse, stating we have our due. Our relationship is reproved, and I gain reputation. Now my reputation is -1. Well, that's awesome. Recruit volunteers. Go to the village center. I need to talk to this guy about recruiting people here. I do need to get my party numbers at least back up to 27, so that I have a maximum shipload of people. Jebediah Kerman, how you doing? Yeah, horse and a lance. Don't know. Okay, Oleaf. I am recruiting. Here's 500 pennings. I can recruit in this village now. Excellent. Let's recruit some volunteers. Recruit some freedmen. Let's leave. Okay. Let's check our character. Let's actually save the game first so we don't crash out on screen transition. Character. Renown. I just need 2 more renown. Oh, God. Okay. Let's ask if this guy has a quest for me. I gotta go back to the village center. Yep. Just started watching. Is the expansion worth it? I think it's fun. Now, I only paid $10 for this, and I think it's worth $10, even with the bugs. But $15 for the regular asking price is a bit too much, I think. But it is fun, and it is more Mountain Blade, and it's got better graphics and newer faces and just all kinds of cool stuff. Give me a task. Bandits are driven away our cattle. Our pastures are empty. I really can't do this quest because it's so irritating to drive the cattle. How many animals do you need? I think 5 heads will suffice for a small herd. No, we'll just do a different mission. Let's go to this village down here. We'll just do a different mission. Yes. Want no crashes, enable single threading. Okay, 5 can follow me. Excellent. Right! I need to find a mission. Derp, 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 derp. Go to the village center. Okay. Hi, dude. How you doing? Local leader. Any tasks? Thank you, sir. We don't need anything. Oh, man. We don't need anything. Silly Billy. We just need 2 more renown. Save the game. Let's go to Reba. See if there's anything there for us again. I just need 2 more renown before we can continue. Okay. Reba. Town's loaded. Stroll through the town. Let's see if there's a quest here for us. Always bring out your best weapon. Never know when you might get assaulted. Yeah, holiday sale on Steam. That's a good time to do it as well. Okay, let's see. I knew that. Where's that guy? Is so elusive, I tell you. There he is. No, wait, he's just the portmaster. Where's the mayor? Mayor's over here. Okay, I will. Don't worry, I'll save the game before we talk. I don't want that dialogue option to disappear. That would be terrible. This game has me talking all oldie fashioned style. We wouldn't want it to lose our stuff. Here's a lovely palisade wall. This is a nice touch. I'm guessing the mayor is going to be behind here. This is probably the prison guard right here, if I were to make a guess. Yep. Well, the mayor's not behind the palisade wall, then where would they be? Here. Guy. Prison guard. Okay, that's the prison guard. That's funny. You don't seem very much near the prison, sir. Okay. This must be the mayor. This is the mayor. Gosh darn it. Halvard, where have you been all my life? I've killed some looters. Aye, my scout saw the whole thing. That should make the bounty. The bounty is 40 pence for every band, so that makes 40 bands in promo. Yep. Anything else you would need? Not yet, sir. Oh, that's right. We can't, we gotta keep doing that quest. Oh, darn it. Okay. So, somewhere there is more bandits. Somewhere there be bandits. Where do you think they'll be? Can you swim? Nope. Not swim. Any bandits around here? Yeah, them bandits. What's my army doing? Okay, we can't up. My companions. I forgotted that we needed to do that. Okay. Got everything there. Of course, I've got such a huge bonus in tactics right now that I don't think, not with the numbers that we have right now anyway, that we're going to be outnumbered by any bands for a while. Maybe a lord will have a quest for us. Forgot that you can ask them too. Killing a murderer will give us the renown we need. Visit the Lord's Hall. Got the spearmen there. Odin priest. Pfft. Oh wait, there he is. I am Crawmerax. Yes. Sound like a good man to know. Let us speak together from time to time. There is something I would like to discuss with you in private. Do you have any tasks? I would hire a company of mercenaries for an upcoming campaign. Oh. I can get in good with the king through this, too. Aye, I'll join the kingdom of Danmark. Perfect, of course we shall have to make a formal declaration of allegiance and give your oath that you and the company will remain in service. Your enemies are my enemies. Okay, so let's see, who are we at war with? Everybody? Awesome. Okay, that will do. You've made a wise choice, friend. The kingdom of Danmark does well by its loyal fighters. Alright, so you should prepare for a serious campaign. Train and equip my soldiers. Must beg my leave. Okay, so this way we will get clued in to when there's going to be a battle and we can get renown that way. So this is going to be cool. We haven't done this yet. So let's save the game. And I guess now we can raid let's go to like the character report here. Where's the kingdom inventory here. Notes. Locations. Factions. A lot of factions. Visible wall. Mail is so shiny. I know. I think that might be a lighting bug. I think. Like, because it looks like it's halogen bulbs up there. Okay, I need 3 more soldiers to have a full company that can get on my boat. So, 3 more people, and we can sail around, looking perhaps for more opportunities. I could also try to train up my men while we wait. That might give me renown as well. Recruit volunteers. 4 freedmen. Recruit them. Leave. Okay, and army. We need to get rid of just one person. Okay, and now we have a full crew. We have a full crew. We have a full crew for that boat. Alright. Let's see if we can train them. There was the option to train them. Visit the training grounds. Competition master, talk. Good day, friend. If you came to the tournaments, you came in vain. There won't be a tournament here anytime soon. Yeah. Fights. Tell me about fights. 0 reward. Good thing. That's what I'm going to do. Okay, so we could get 2 renown by doing this. Come on, buddy. Ow. Okay, I wasn't ready that time. That was a practice. No fair, you got around me. No fair. Alright, I'm taking a lot of damage here. Come on, I just need 2 renown. You'll give me 2 renown if I kill you, right? Okay. Okay. I'm gonna get dongered again. No surprise there. Yep, dongered. But that's okay, we can try again. Okay, about the melee fights. Try again. Okay, finally, they gave me a real man's weapon. That's a good... Oh, crap. I can donger you with my sword. Okay. Stop dongering me. Stop clipping through each other. See, what happens when I get a sword? Everything just goes so much better. Think you can beat me with that little dagger? Alright. The key to winning these fights is to try to make sure that you don't let that they spawn in every little once in a while. So you have to make sure that you have no more than one opponent on the field at any particular time. Out. I wonder how many people you need to defeat. Oh, it's up there on the counter. Is it just me or is that more than usual? Okay, wow. Alright, man. Okay, come on, buddy. Ow! Didn't mean to do that. Oh! See, that's what happens when you get careless. Okay. Did I get any renown for that? I wasn't paying attention. Character? No, nope, I didn't get any renown, so that was a waste of time. Is there a tournament I could possibly be in? Oh, right.
No, there isn't. I was just there.
Dumb peep. Dumb scourge. Court, I guess. Follow the king. Accompany the king! Dirt, 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 dirt. Accompanying the king. And let's save the game. Nothing going on. Where's the faction report? That's really what I want to look at. Relations info. Faction relations. Friendly, friendly. King of Northvegar. King of Lathland. Kingdom of Denmark. Different hostile. Looks like we're at war with East Anglia and Alban. Okay. We're at war with East Anglia and Albany. We may just want to go over there and start up trouble. Yeah, have to kill them all for any reward. Yeah, yeah. Wait a second. Thieves. There we go. And you're blue. Come on. Time to die.
You may not be a manhunter.
Charge the enemy. Let's see how much renown I'll get for this battle. Zero renown. You gotta be snotting me. Okay, well, everybody can hold their fire and everyone can charge. I just want you to get up in there, get up in their faces, and do this quickly. This is one of the... bands of thieves that we need to get to. Talk to him. I didn't talk to him when he came back, because he didn't have any... he didn't tell me I needed to speak to him for the reward. What's going on over here? I told you all to charge, and you're like... playing a doofus. Not charging. What are you guys doing? Oh, there is an invisible wall here. What the fudge? Okay, so there was... that's an invisible wall. There is something... there that is blocking people. It blocked me, even. Wow. Swellus, welcome back. Wombat, welcome to the stream. Okay, well, we won the battle despite random invisible walls. So that's a bug. We gain one morale. Bad the loot. We have some stuff we need to sell, actually. Let's get back to Reba. Maybe I can get myself a frickin' horse. Okay. Trade with the locals. Trade with the goods merchant. Let's sell all this jazz. All of it. Get out of here, stuff. They did rebalance the price on a lot of these things. Like, you can easily get 1,000 per battle. Trade with the horse merchant. Can I get a pony? Nope. 9,000 for a pony. Crazy, guys. I do need to stroll through town and get my fee for those looters we killed. Halvard killed some looters. Okay, so there's still some left. There was another party over there somewhere. My army ready to upgrade? No. There were training camps I could train people in. I need 2 renown. Maybe this guy has a new job for me. Kills wombat, lets his corpse rot, makes biscuit from his entrails. Rotten wombat tripe biscuits. Come on, dude. Surely you have a... ask for me. Okay, local leader. Have you seen any enemies here? No, sir, we haven't seen any war parties. Okay. Memory tasks. Nope. Oh, that's just great. I need tumor now, and I'm not getting it. Surely there is a battle here to be had. Oh, I can get some renown. You know what? Let's sail to East Anglia and save it first. Let's sail to East Anglia and join the war effort over there. Bonk. Could be a straight shot from where we are. Sailing across the sea. Shadowfang, run, run, run. Welcome to the stream. We are trying to get two renown is all we need. Just two renown. Thieves? Well, let's kill them. Surrender or die. Board the enemy. I get one renown. All right, that's half our goal. Okay. Row, row, row your boat gently down the sea. Oh, they have two boats. Okay. Get ready, Ben. Pull up alongside. Yeah, here we go. Everyone charge. Board their boat. Steal their boats. Alright. And these guys pull up alongside here. You killed one of my men, how dare you? And you made Brunhild fall unconscious, you sons of gitches. Sons of gitches. And I didn't do anything because my guy was glitched in a corner. I didn't say anything at it at the time. Alright, cool. Battle one. One was killed, one was wounded. Killed the 13 ruffians. Order to share the loot. Dirty shoes, fustabulous, general stuff. Boy, it is hard to level up in this. Can't kill anybody. Okay, so we didn't get any boats from that. That's upsetting. We have their boats now. I feel like we should have their boats. We need more horsemen. Okay. I wonder what these guys do. What can they turn into? A freeholder. They can turn into Bondi, Bringer, Thing, and Noble. Huh. Obviously the better way to do it. Going down the Huskarl route. Okay. Done. So, we need one more battle. Raider. Landing point. Let's find a landing point here. Oh, there. Nope. Landing point. Landing point! There we go. To land. Also save the game. A party is spotted. Well, Danish elite... Wait. Danish elite... Okay, we probably shouldn't try to take those guys on. They'll kill my newbies. And those guys are all coming for me. And those guys are coming for me. And we're screwed. Render now or we'll kill you all. We will fight to the end. Start the battle holding position. They have very strong toes. That's right. Not enough troops to form a shield wall. Okay, I don't know why it's about talking about divisions. Okay. Where are these guys? Seriously. Alright, backspace! Okay, they're coming. Are they? No, they are not. But, by using the minimap there, I realize that their leader is off to the side there all by himself, like a doofus. So we can probably kill him and get the rest of them to run away. Iosevis, welcome! Under the monastery in Friese for renown. You really want me to fudge up those monasteries, and I really can't because I am a Christian character. Now, if there's like a grove of Odin or something, I'm pretty sure we can screw that up for renown. Sounds like a bad plan. I'm sure it's fine. It's fine. Where are they? Why does it keep pausing the game? Okay, that person, or that singular, there he is! Do you see him? Off there in the distance? Go fudge him up. Go fudge him up. Fudgy, fudgy, fudge, fudge. Yeah, try to throw a spear, why don't you? You're all on your own lonesome, you fool. Kill him! Gank him! Clip your weapons through him like you do me. Overhand chop! Oh, he is tough. Ship captain killed. Okay. Well, where are you guys going? Where are you guys going? Don't do what you're doing. Okay. Any other isolated people? Nope, this is the land deployment. They see the character. You see him over there? Fuck him up. Okay. So we can pelt them for a while. Oh, they're pelting us! Oh, crap. Well, this is an unforeseen development. Yeah. We might want to charge now. We may want to also say, hold your fire, and then charge. Whoa! Alright, I killed somebody and leveled up. I don't know how. All my guys are dying. I can't tell friend from foe, so I'm just gonna flail. It looks like we might actually be winning, though. That's an enemy right there. Where is he? There we go. Wow. Alright. So let's see. I got 3 Frisians were killed. 5 freemen were killed. Oh, crap. Total 9. 7 killed or seriously wounded. 4 killed or seriously wounded. 1 minor wounded. Dang. Vikinger. Alright. Looks like we have some Bondi we can train. I can level up and so can Bodo. Awesome. Order to share the loot. Rusty Bernie with fur. Ooh, this is much better than what I've got. Doink. A battered old Norseman helm, yep. Let's see, sturdy shoes, ragged long gambeson. Okay, so we need to equip our compatriots again. But pretty good here. Alright, I gained 2 morale for the loot we shared, and I'm assuming we got some renown for that. So that worked out rather well. Renown, 207. Cha-ching! Mail's gonna help tons, yeah. Yeah. Okay, so army. Freedman, upgrade you to Bondi. You up here with the horseman. Brunhilde is wounded. Crawmerax, I can level up myself, but I'll do that later. Bodo! Let us talk. Let's see yourself about equipment. Bodo, you can take my old armor. I don't think we have anything that gives you better leg. We do have this helmet you can wear. And actually... Yeah, this is better. Actually, this is better. There we go. And... Yes, I think... Okay, yeah, he's pretty good on the weapons front, I think. We'll keep him on an axe. And he can level up now. Let's see, what is his job? He could be he's maxed out on training. Spotting. We need somebody who's good at spotting, so he'll be the spotter. Pole arms and one-handed weapons. We'll get him. He has pole arms. Okay, anything else? Never mind. Okay, raging hard. Let's talk. See your equipment. You can take my old thing. And you have an old Norse helm here. Okay, and in terms of weapons, you can get a war spear. That's better than what you've got, isn't it? 16 blunt. Oh yeah, that's better than what you've got. There you go. War spear. Ooh. Tattered quality wrapping boots. And ragged wrapping boots. They need to distribute that. Actually, this is better than the one I have, so we'll trade. Okay. And... Right? We need to get this to, is there anything good here? I could... Okay. Never mind. We need to go back to Bodo. Boots. Bodo the boots! You need the boots! There you go. Let's see. Alright. And last but not least, we need to talk to... Brunhild, fuck. Let me see your equipment, ma'am. Let's upgrade you, if we can. Oh no, I gave away all my actual armor to other people. There's a better boot around here somewhere. Yes. Do we have any helmets for her? Nope. Okay. Well, I'm sorry. Pull them back if it's a tough battle. You're noobs in another group. Anything else? Nothing really. Alright. Alright, gang, so here's the plan. It's almost 9 o'clock and I haven't had dinner yet, but I feel like we really need to get on our ship and save the game and talk to the king. We'll advance the plot by one mission. So we'll play one more story mission, and then I'll call it a stream. How about that? Forgotten your fudges. Alright, Crawmerax's ship. Let's get the fudge out of here. Alright, landing point, away we go. advance the plot by one. Port of Reeb, let's get the dialogue box to show up here. Come on. There we go. That's how you know you're actually clicking on the point on the city where you can actually go to port. That's a landing port. I thought that said trading point. Trading point? Wow. Okay. Now that we're home, let's trade. And, trade with the locals, trade with the goods merchant, sell all this crap. Sell, sell, sell. I need 9,000 for our new pony. Because this is Mountain Blade Viking Conquest. Okay, whoops. Alright, just pay. I don't care about the 10 denars, but let's go to the horse merchant. Sell the rest of this stuff. They have plenty of money. Oh. Let's think of something else here. I do care about the 100. Okay. Turn trade with the armorer. Okay. Does the horse merchant actually have anything I can buy? I can buy a pony. Bonk. Thank you for the pony. All right. That was a good trade. I like that. Now let us save the game and talk to the king and advance the plot. And the king is on the water. What? Okay, whatever. I guess I need to go into port. And, sail from the port. And then talk to him. Bonk! We meet again, Crawmerax. On the sea. That is correct, sir. I am from Friese. I need to talk to you about an important issue. You have my interest. I am listening to you. I need to talk to you about Sigurd. Oh! Sigurd Ragnarsson is one of my jarls. We have nothing to talk about. You understand? Are we finished, or do you need something else? Okay. Oh. Okay. Seems you will not have the help of the king. You'll have to help. Okay, so I need to game it. Alright, so folks, it seems like whatever I need, I do not have. Yeah, just continue the quest anyway. I can. Cross your fingers and see if it works. Yeah, it's not looking like it's gonna work. Let's replenish our men before we do anything, I guess. Let's go ahead and talk to Snake in the Eye himself. Recruit volunteers. Two freedmen want to join. Alright, we need 6 more men to max out our crew. Okay. So it must be even higher than 200. Who volunteers? 7 freedmen. Holy crap. I'm only going to disband them disband the one if it turns out. In fact, let's these up as well. Let's make sure all the veterans are up front. Okay. Okay. Let's confront what's his face. Sigurd. Let's confront Sigurd. We haven't gotten any quests to be part of a war party or anything. Which is pretty amazing. do need to stroll through town. And, sell our slaves before we do anything else. We don't miss much of just a line of dialogue. Okay, Daniel Cullinane, welcome! Yeah, let's go to Sigurd. So after we sell the slaves here, we'll go to Sigurd. Save a traitor. Brought some prisoners. Those were worth a lot. Okay. Who is here? King. I know we can ask the king where Sigurd is. Alright, let's game it. Let's just ask the king where Sigurd is. I wish to ask you something. I want a location of someone. Jarl Sigurd. The field of mummies should be close to Hide-a-Bearer at the moment. Okay. Hide-a-Bearer. Yes. Away! Hey, to Hide-a-Bearer. And eventually we'll have to buy it, either buy or acquire a spear so I can be a cavalry person. Okay, Jarl Siegfried. Let's see here. Jarl Sigurd. Alright, snake in the eye. Oh! My name is Crawmerax. What is it? Let's save the game real quick. Okay. Hi. I am from Friese. I'm looking for Sven Bull-Neck and my mother. Where are they? I do not care who you are or what your motives may be. Here in Danmark, you're nobody, someone insignificant. You have neither credentials nor support. I say it only once. Get out of my presence, rat. Oh, look, he does have snake eyes. Look. Oop. I clicked on it. All right. There's something I wish to ask you in private. Okay, well, it looks like we're stymied here. Let's maybe ask an admission from him. I have something you could help me with. He murdered one of my men. Okay. I'll hunt him down and execute the law. I'll get some reputation with him, I guess. He was hiding out by Hideabye. Okay. Oh, that's a shame. That's a shame. Okay. Go to the village center. Alright, cool. Finally fight from horseback. So I am looking for a no-good-nick. Sir, do you know where a no-good-nick is? Okay, this is just like the Mountain Blade quest, so we should be looking for a static man hiding probably right here. Nope, that's a townsman. Maybe it's this man with a shield. Nervous man, yep. Hawk. I am looking for a murderer. Alright, then drop your sword. I'm coming here not for money, but to execute the law. The law? You know, like from Judge Dredd, that horrible movie. Alright, come on. It smells. Alright. Killed him. Killed him dead. Okay. And was that one of my... No, that wasn't one of my recruiting villages. Okay, so let's go back. Collect my reward. Not Siegfried. Okay, come on. Where? Show me who's here. No, he's not here. Alright. Wait, what happened? He refused to tell me anything. and the plot could not advance. So I did a mission. I'm doing a mission for him, and maybe that will. I don't think so. I think we need a much higher reputation. Much higher. Where is he? Gosh darn it. It was just around here a moment ago. Alright, well, let's ask this guy. Surely he knows. No, I don't want any tasks. I need to ask you something. Jarl Sigurd. Rosa Hadabur. Okay, so he is over there, apparently. He is over there. Yeah, there he is. Well, what is it? All the tasks you gave me. I gave him his punishment. I got 300 experience. Alright. You are a man for whom justice is your only reward. Eh? As you wish it, Crawmerax, as you wish it. An honorable sentiment to be true. I gained reputation. I got some relations with him. Okay, let's see if he will tell me now. I do not care who you are. Okay. Fine. It's not going to help me or do anything. Well, gang, you know what? He's not going to help me, and it's going to take considerably more than time than I think I have. So tell you what, let's save the game, and let us campaign with Sigurd on the next stream. Ah, you're probably right, Lord Zero. You're probably right. But in any case, whatever we'll do will take longer than I have, so I want to thank you all for watching. It was great seeing so many new faces in here. If you like the stream, please do give me a follow. I will be streaming this tomorrow. Tomorrow, probably around 1 or 2 in the afternoon, Eastern time. And again, if you follow the stream, you'll get a notification of when I go live. We will do that suggestion of talking to the king first and then talking to Sigurd. But like I said, I don't think we can advance the plot by a mission with the time I have left. That little bit ate up just enough time. But again, I want to thank you all for watching, and I really appreciate it. If you like what you saw, please do consider giving me a follow, and I will, well, see you all in here about 1 or 2 p.m. Eastern Time tomorrow for more Mountain Blade Viking Conquest. Thanks again, and have a great evening. How am I ever going to play multiplayer? Yeah, at some point. I would like to at least complete the story campaign first to get used to the game. But yes, likely I will. And I'll probably stream that as well. But in any case, and until next time, I'd like to say a goodbye and thanks again for watching.